Welcome to week two as the San Francisco 49ers take on the Carolina Panthers. Carolina Panthers are 1-0 to start the season after defeating the Denver Broncos on opening Thursday night, and San Francisco 49ers are 0-1 after a disappointing loss on Monday night last week against the Los Angeles Rams, giving up a lot of rushing yards to Todd Gurley and the Los Angeles Rams offense, hoping to improve on that this week as they take on the touted Carolina Panthers run game. So we'll see if this will be a big test for the 49ers to see if they made progress from week one. And here is the opening kickoff. The 49ers, Phil Dawson, will kick it deep to Ted Ginn, I believe, is back there to return. No, this is Philly Brown with a spin move out to the 25. That's where the Panthers will start the ball. And the shotgun, Cam Newton with Jonathan Stewart to his left. The handoff to Jonathan Stewart up the middle. Tries to break a tackle and get outside, but is brought down after a nice game. Offensive line for the Panthers, followed by the backs and receivers with Greg Olsen, Ted Ginn Jr., and as I mentioned already, Jonathan Stewart. Second and seven now in the first drive of the game for the Panthers. Noon fakes the pass to the right, hands it to Stewart up the middle, who gets a gain of about 14 and good enough for a first down. Panthers moving the ball well on the first two runs of the game. In the pistol formation, now Jonathan Stewart with the handoff to the right side gets outside of Navarro Bowman onto the right and finally brought down Bethea. But enough for a first down. That's about three rushes for 35 yards to start the game. Good start for the Panthers. Bad start for the 49ers defense. There's a good play by Ahmad Brooks for a tackle for a loss against Jonathan Stewart. Here's another run. Oh, nope. It's a play action passing over the middle, and that is caught by Kelvin Benjamin, who breaks one tackle, breaks another tackle, is finally brought down by Bethy at the 15. Cam Newton under center here with Jonathan Stewart in the backfield. Tolbert at the offset eye and runs up the middle, but there is nothing there as Demario Bowman makes a tackle, but unfortunately it's called for a face mask, and that will be an automatic first down with the ball at the 7-yard line. Here's a look at the San Francisco 49ers defense led by DeForest Buckner and Eric Armstrong up front. Aaron Lynch and Ahmad Brooks with Navarro Bowman at the linebackers. Secondary-wise, Antoine Bethea, Tremont Brake, Jimmy Ward. And here we go, second and goal at the 7-yard line. Cam Newton under center, fake screen out to the right, but hands it off to Stewart, who cuts through the line and gets to about the 5-yard line. They'll set up third and goal at the 5. 49ers would love to get a stop here to start off the game, giving up only a field goal. Throws to the right side, and that is knocked away. Great play there by Jimmy Ward. And that was against Kelvin Benjamin. They'll set up a field goal. Here comes Blaine Gabbert to lead the offense to the 49ers. He had a nice week, over 300 yards passing, 2 touchdowns, and 2 interceptions. He'll start the game off here with a pass. Drops back to pass. Off his back foot, throws it to McDonald down the flat, who gets close to a first down, but I think he'll be marked just short for second and inches. Blaine Gabbert in the shotgun with Mike Davis to his right. And there's going to be a read option, a handoff to Mike Davis. So it gets enough for a first down, gain of 4 to get the first down of the game. Blaine Gabbert again. And shotgun is back to pass, looking, dumps it off to Carlos Hyde this time in the flat, who tries to run over the defensive back, but gets brought out of downs for a 20-yard gain. Blaine Gabbert making a change at the line. Blaine Gabbert back to pass now. Good protection, throws it deep over the middle for Quentin Patton for a nice catch. That's a play for 20 yards. First down into the red zone of Carolina Panthers. 49ers are back to pass again, looking to the right, dumps it off to the left side to Blake Bell, the tight end, and that gets him to 2nd and 1. 49ers are trying to match the Panthers or even do one better and get a touchdown on this first drive. There's a run up the middle for a first down to the 5-yard line, but let's see what the flag is. And it is holding against the offense. That is Joshua Garnett, the rookie. So that'll put him in a rough position at 2nd and 1 on the 20-yard line. See the handoff to Carlos Hyde, tries to run over one tackle, but is brought down at the 21-yard line. That's a loss of 1. 49ers here see what they do on a 3rd and 12. They are just going to fake the screen, do a handoff to Sean Drone, who runs over one man and is brought down. They settled for that field goal just to tie it up. This is probably a good play after what happened last week, trying to stay in the game this week. Cam Newton with all the time in the world to throw. Passes it deep for Kelvin Benjamin. Oh no, that was Philly Brown. And that is incomplete as he overshot him. Great protection up front by the O-line. Need better pressure by the D-line. Cam Newton under center now. Hands off to Jonathan Stewart. And he is brought down by Gerald Hodges and Ahmad Brooks behind the line. Or right at the line. This sets up a 3rd and 9 here. Cam Newton under center. See what they do here. He's back to pass. Good protection up front. Oh, and Kelvin Benjamin is wide open over the middle of the field. Looks like the 49ers played a cover 3 defense, and the Panthers just ran 4 verts for a first down. and they are now in 49ers territory. Cam Newton, empty set, shotgun, making an audible here. Play cut running down. Here's Cam Newton back to pass, but still plenty of time to find Benjamin on the right side with a curl route. Might be enough for a first down and right into the red zone again, just like they did last time, seeing if they can get a touchdown instead of just settle for the field goal. Jonathan Stewart up the middle for a nice carry of 4 yards, brought down by Eric Armstead. Cam Newton again with Jonathan Stewart on center, and that is not a false start. That is an offside that drew the offensive men to flinch. So that'll be offsides on Eric Armstead, and that'll set up a second and one. Unfortunate there to give him this field position after a manageable 2nd and 6 for the defense. But here are the Panthers now. It's a run to the left side, and it's brought up by Reed, the free safety, but he gets enough for the first down after a gain tackle. 1st and goal again, meet the Panthers, see if they can get a touchdown now. There's a run to the left side, which a huge tackle by Navarro Bowman, blowing it up right at the line of scrimmage. Luckily, Jonathan Stewart was able to hold on to the ball right there. Linebackers shift to the left here. Greg Olsen in motion. There's going to be another handoff to the left, and this time it's brought down by Aaron Lynch behind the line of scrimmage. Two back-to-back great plays by this 49ers defense. That'll bring us to the end of the first quarter with a score of 3-3. Each team getting a field goal on the first possession. Now we get start of the second quarter here with 3rd and goal. Cam Newton in the pistol. Cam Newton is back to pass, rolling to the right. He's going to run for it. He spins, and he is brought down just short, and that will set up a field goal opportunity for the Panthers, and they take it. Here is the ensuing kickoff. There's a nice return by Quinn Patton that gets them all the way down to the 45-yard line. Great field position. See if the 49ers can capitalize and try and take the lead on this possession after two good red zone stands by their defense. There's Carlos Hyde off the side of left to make it 3rd and a manageable 5. Empty here for Blaine Gabbert. Back to pass. Throws it to the flats to the right side to Quinn Patton. He's fighting for the first down, but there's a gang of Panthers, and it will be just short. They have to punt the ball back to the Carolina Panthers. Unfortunately, after great field position. With a full house set up here for the Panthers. Hands it off to Stewart, who runs it up the middle. Gerald Hodges runs right by and breaks another tackle, and it's finally brought down by Eric Reed. Cam Newton in shotgun makes the audible check. He's going to hand it off to Jonathan Stewart to the right side, and that is gobbled up there by Navarro Bowman. Navarro Bowman is all over the place so far this game. That's already his second tackle for loss against Jonathan Stewart. Sets up a 2nd and 12. Coach is happy right there for the 49ers. He's playing a lot better run defense after the first drive gave up some pretty gashing runs. Cam Newton is back to pass, throws it over the middle for a check down to Greg Olsen, and gain of 6. Sets up a 3rd and 5. Cam Newton and shotgun again. See what they do. They have trips on the right, and they throw it to the right, and that is caught by Ed Dixon, but the throw made him come back for the ball, and he ended up just short of the first down marker. They had to punt back to the 49ers. On the first play of the next drive, Carlos Hyde runs it to the right side, but gets nothing. He's had 4 rushes for 4 yards total. Blaine Gabbert back to pass. Or in the shotgun, making a quick change there. See what he changes to. Back to pass. Pressure on him. Throws it deep to the left side for Torrey Smith. And that is a catch going up over the top. Great catch by Torrey Smith. That'll be a huge catch for Torrey Smith to get set 1st and 10 in Carolina Panthers territory. Come back with a run on the next play. And that is nothing again. As Carlos Hyde cannot get going in the early parts of this game. Do a little shift here by the 49ers. Get the play to the left side. Looks like there's a fake handoff, a screen to the left side to Torrey Smith, and that is going to be good for about 3 yards, 2 or 3 yards there. Sets up a 3rd and 8. 49ers looking to get first down and extend this drive and get in field goal range to tie up the game. Blaine Gabbert back to pass, throws it to the left side off his back foot, and that's caught by Dre's Anderson. Enough for the first down, just barely, as he was able to fall forward on that tackle. Carlos Hyde in the backfield takes it in a handoff. This time, finally, he's able to get some positive yardage, 5 yards in that time, because that matched his previous 5 rushes. Blaine Gabbert in pistol. Another handoff to Carlos Hyde, and that is going to be just a couple more yards to set up 3rd and 3. Finally gained some run, at least a little bit of run production right there. Try to draw the Panthers offsides, throws it over the middle for Sean Drone, who drops it. That would have been a first down and maybe more. Could have made a man miss and get a touchdown, but 49ers will settle for the field goal. Mick ties it up at 6-6 with 4 minutes to go in the quarter. Jonathan Stewart with the run up middle, and that is tackled. Remember, end of the second quarter was a big-time mess for the 49ers last week. See if they can hold on to this tie as this week happens. as they pass to the left side, and that is going to be enough for a first down. So far, not looking too good for the 49ers on this drive. Cam Newton under center with Tolbert in motion to the right side. Jonathan Stewart hand up the middle, and that is tackled. That time it was by Eric Reed and Navarro Bowman. Great plays by them I've seen so far today. 49ers giving the nickel look, and that is a great job by, I believe that was DeForest Buckner, shading the tackle and making the tackle right at the line of scrimmage. Again, and then a nickel. Cam Newton back to pass, throws a slant to Kelvin Benjamin. That's going to be just short. That will set up a 4th-and-1 in a punting situation. But the 49ers were unable to do anything with that possession, as that will send us to halftime with the score of 6-6. So far, it's been a defensive battle, as you can see there. 49ers cannot get the run game going, and it has cost them because they've had to rely on the pass, and once they get down in the red zone, there's less room to work for the pass, and that hurts them. But they will start with the ball here for the second half. It'll be run to Carlos Hyde to the right side, but heads it back to the left, and then he's hit and fumbled. Hit and fumbled on the very first play of the second half. That is not what the 49ers needed here. Now Cam Newton is looking to capitalize on this great field position. He's back to pass. He looked to the left, he looked to the right. Now he's rolling to the right. He's going to scramble, and that is going to be a nice spin move for a first down. Looked like he was going to go out of bounds, but instead gets the first down. Now it's 1st and 10 at 17 in a pistol full house formation again for Cam Newton and the Panthers offense. Run to the right side. Jonathan Stewart makes a man miss, tries to run over a guy, and is ended up tackled by Aaron Lynch. Looks like he could have just got a touchdown if he didn't try to run over that defensive back, but he went for the contact instead. See if that pays off for them. There's a run of the middle for Jonathan Stewart, and he is brought down. Nice fill by Antoine Bethea, and it was nice off-the-edge pressure by Eric Reed. Our safeties are playing well, and run help this today. And there is, another tackle. Navarro Bowman with the first hit, but DeForest Buckner ended up making the tackle. Sets up a 3rd and goal. 49ers in a 3-3-5 defense here, was showing some pressure. Looks like they had a cover two, and Cam Newton has nowhere to throw. Great coverage downfield by the 49ers. That is a coverage sack right there that Eric Armstead will benefit from. Showing a little dance right there. He's got 2 sacks in 2 games so far to start the season. Here is the first play on the next drive. Carlside runs over the defensive back for the Panthers, but only gets 2 yards. Sean Jones checks into the game now. Is it going to hand off to him? No, it is a read option. That is a poor read by Blaine Gabbert. That would be a loss of 4 yards. So set up a 3rd and 12 at their own 23. See if we can get a first down here. There's a motion man out of the backfield, throws it over the middle, and that is dropped by Curley. And it wouldn't matter because there is a holding on the play by the offense, again by Joshua Garnett. He has looked very poor so far in the run game and very poor in terms of penalties. You know, the Panthers trying to extend their lead. There's a broken tackle, but then he is brought down by Navarro Bowman. So it's a 2nd and 4. Cam Newton in the shotgun here in 2nd and 4, and there's a run up the middle to Jonathan Stewart, and he was hit by Aaron Lynch and ended up being brought down again by Navarro Bowman. Bowman is all over the place today. Looks like 49ers are coming out in a sugar look with linebackers in double A gap, and they're going to bring the heat, but it was blocked pretty well, and the Panthers got a couple yards on that first down play. Now it's 2nd and 7 here with the Carolina Panthers up 9-6 and 7 minutes to go in the third quarter with the motion man. Cam Newton is back to pass. Great time, rolls to his right, and is caught by Jonathan Stewart in the middle, who shoves off Tart, actually. The backup strong safety was in on that play. And Tart got shoved off of that one, unable to make the tackle. So they'll go right back to Stewart after breaking a tackle there. He's going to see if he can break some more, and carries 2 defenders for 5 extra yards. Sets up the 1st and 10 at the 11-yard line. And the running back is Cameron Artis Payne, and that'll be a nice gain of 5 yards, his first rush on the day, giving a break to Jonathan Stewart after he's got heavy workload. Cam Newton and shotgun on 2nd and 5 at the 6, rolling to the right, and that is complete to Kelvin Benjamin, but he's short of the first down and the goal line, so it is 3rd and 2 from the 3. See if the 49ers can force another red zone field goal. That would be huge and very disappointing for the Panthers. There's going to be a run up the middle, and he is not going to get there. Great fill by Hodges and the defensive line to hold the line. This is a 4 redstone field goals today for the Carolina Panthers. 49ers are really doing the bend, don't break defense. And right there, Carlos Hyde runs over Luke Kuechly for the first down. That is the best run so far on the day by Carlos Hyde. Sets up, gets the 49ers the first down of the drive, which is typically the hardest. Blaine Gabbert back to pass, throws it to the right side for Carlos Hyde, who tiptoes down the sideline, and for a gain of 7 yards. So far, Carlos Hyde has been the featured guy on this drive. Let's see if that continues. on 2nd and 3. Gabbert back to pass, throws to the right side, and that is incomplete into a tight window. That would have been a nice catch if they could have hooked up on that one. Sets up a 3rd and 3. Gabbert still back to pass. And he's going to throw it to the right side, and the diving catch for Blake Bell, and he makes a nice catch for the first down. That was a high throw by Gabbert, but a good catch. Seeing a lot of the two tight end sets here for the 49ers so far today. Really liking with the get out Blake Bell, and that is thrown over the middle, almost intercepted by Luke Kuechly. Lucky it was not. Intended for, I believe that was intended for Jeremy Curley. Sets up a 2nd and 10. Rod Streeter on the right side, throws it to Streeter this time, and is in his hands, but then is dropped. Dropped by Rod Streeter. It was a great read and a great throw by Gabbert, but dropped into middle coverage. That's a catch he has made. Sets up a screen here on 3rd and 10, and Drone runs into the back of his tackle and is end up tackled there, and the 49ers do not get the first down. Give the ball back to the Panthers. Panthers here on 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Throws it to the left side, and that is falling, but it is a catch to set up 2nd and 4 here with a minute to go in the third quarter. 49ers are going to need to get a stop and give the ball back to their offense. Hope they can make something happen. There's a great play by Terrence Cody to shed the tackle and make the tackle right at the line of scrimmage. Great job by our nose tackle. First time we've called him, get his name in the first two games, I believe. Here's a play-action pass on 3rd and 3 and throws it to the right for Greg Olsen, who beat his man and then ends up being tackled by Eric Reed. He beat his man and then just threw on the corner route, and it was an easy pitch and catch for Cam Newton. Cam Newton again with the fake screen, looking, pressure in his face, throwing deep, and that is knocked away. Nice job by Tremaine Brock to end the third quarter. Panthers are up 12-6 after 4 made field goals. The 2nd and 10 at the 49ers 43. Can't give up many more yards. They're going to get a field goal, and that is not what the 49ers needed. That is a 8-yard rush on 2nd down to set up 3rd and 1. 3rd and 1 here. 49ers again coming in the sugar look with the double linebackers and A-gap. Trying to hold them here to set up a long field goal attempt, and that is, he has hit the line, broke a tackle, and then he is brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Eric Reed with his tackle for a loss. I couldn't see there who was the first guy who made contact, but that'll set up a long field goal. A 57-yarder into the wind. Let's see if they make this to go up 2x2 scores. The snap is good, hold is good, and it is in there to go up 15-6. That is a big field goal and make this a 2-score game. It's going to be difficult for the 49ers to come back the way they've been moving the ball today. Blaine Gabbert back to pass, throwing over the middle, and that is caught by Vance McDonald, enough for the first down. Vance McDonald has had a kind of a quiet game after starting out the year so strong last year. Here is a run middle for on first down, but that gets nothing. Mike Davis only got 2 yards on that play. Blaine Gabbert again with a double tight end look. This time Selleck replacing McDonald. Gabbert back to pass and throws to the left side. That is caught by Blake Bell, who is drilled at right at the first down line. Bring him up short for a 3rd and 1. Double tight end look again here. Gabbert back to pass, throws the smash route to the left side, and that is caught by Dre's Anderson for the first down. Anderson has shown great hands and gained into the open spots on the defense. He might get some more playing time. There's a fake to the left, and then a throwback for the tight end screen on the right side, but that is lucky that was not intercepted, as the did not fool the Carolina Panthers defense. Again, back to pass. Gabbert looking, got good time, throws on the right side. Oh, and caught by Jeremy Curley, one-handed over top of the defender. That was his first catch and first target of the day, and he made it worthwhile. Makes it so we should throw the ball at him more often, is what I heard from that one. Here's a run. It looks to be to the right side, but he tries to cut back up the middle, and that is a no gain there for Carlos Hyde, who's had a very disappointing game so far. Can't get the run game going, but not surprised because Carolina Panthers front seven is very, very good. 3rd and 10 here at the 20, or inside the red zone. That is past the right side for Mike Davis on the flats, and the run after catch is enough for the first down to set up first and goal for the 49ers. A touchdown would be big here. Now it's 2nd and goal at the 5-yard line. Here's a run to Sean Drone. Tries to get to the goal line, but it's unfortunate. 49ers ran a similar play last week at that similar position to get the touchdown for Carlos Hyde, but could not right here. Blaine Gabbert audibles out of a play here with 5 wide, and that is a touchdown on 3rd and goal. 49ers needed that. That makes this back to a 1-score game, and that is the first touchdown of the game for either team here in the fourth of the game, and it happens here in the fourth quarter. Score 15-13. 49ers need to stop and then a field goal to take the lead and possibly get their first one of the year. There's a fumble on the first play of the game. Oh, not first play of the game, but first play of the drive, but we could not come up with it. Navarro Bowman drilled him and could not recover that. That would have been huge. It gave us great field position, but instead, Panthers recovered and they still have the ball. Now it is 3rd and 3. As you can see, there's a line to gain. 49ers come out in a 3-4 base defense with the bear look. And that is a handoff to Jonathan Stewart to the right side with a nice spin move. He runs over the corner. I believe that was Tremaine Brock. And there is going to be the only one man left to catch him is Aaron Lynch. And he cannot get him before he gets in the touchdown. That was a great individual effort by Jonathan Stewart. Spinning out of the tackle at the line of scrimmage. And then running over Tremaine Brock in the secondary. And then beating everybody else to the pylon to put the Panthers up by 9. 49ers going to need to get some magic here in the last 6 minutes if they want to win this ball game. Blaine Gabbert back to pass with plenty of time. Throws it over the middle, and that is into the hands of Streeter, and then intercepted by Panthers right there. Again, Streeter had the ball hit his hands, but he could not come up with the catch. Panthers get the ball on this next possession here, 1st and 10. And Noon is back to pass, and he's going to throw it to the left side, and that is caught by Kelvin Benjamin. Panthers are probably going to lean on that run game here to run out that clock and secure this lead. Noon is in the shotgun, which is a play action screen to the right side, and tackled immediately by Kelvin Benjamin for a loss of 2 yards. Cam Noon now under center with a single back. Then 2nd and 12 is going to do a misdirection play action. Cam Noon back to pass. This is 3 passes in a row with all the time in the world and throws it deep over the middle of the field for Ted Good Jr. Comes back to the ball. It was great coverage downfield by the 49ers, but they could not hold on for long enough as the D-line pressure was not there. And great job by Ted Good coming back for the ball way down the field. Gets the ball into the 49ers territory. See if the Panthers are going to run here to try and run out the clock with less than 4 minutes to go in a 2-possession game. No, Cam Newton is back to pass again. Drops and throws it to Ted Ginn Jr. again over the middle on the drag route. But that was a big gain for Ginn with a lot of run after catch to get him into the red zone. Panthers still have the ball here in the red zone. Noon is back to pass again and throws it to Craig Olsen. Panthers have been running the ball great all game. In this drive, they decide to pass it with 4 minutes to go, and they're up 2 possessions. You think it the other way around. Now they're back to pass again with a play action. This time, there was good pressure up front by Terrence Cody. He has to throw it away. They'll set up 3rd and 4 at the 49ers' 8-yard line. If they can get a stop here and it's only 2-position games, you never know. Crazy things happen in the NFL. And there's a run to the left side to Jonathan Stewart, and it is brought down at the near the first down by Navarro Bowman. Great job of shedding the tackle, and he was just short, and that made them kick the field goal. 49ers here on the next possession are going to need a touchdown, onside kick, and a touchdown to take the lead. And this is a good start here for Torrey Smith, who drops it. Oh, no. That would have been huge for the 49ers. He would have been off to the races and most likely getting into the touchdown. That would have been nice. But unfortunately, he dropped it. Here is Mike Davis now up the middle trying to get some yardage here to set up a 3rd and 1. 3rd and 1. Gabbert throws as he is hit and is incomplete. 4th and 1. If they don't get this, this is the ball game. 5 wide here with Sean Drone and Torrey Smith on the left side. Blaine Gabbert back to pass, throws it again up for Torrey Smith on the same route, and this time he catches it with one hand. Makes the catch with one hand, but unable to make the catch when nobody's around him. Unfortunate. This time throws to the right side, and that is incomplete. They have to take deep chances here because their time is running out. Gabbert is in shotgun again, and he's going to take the shotgun snap and throw it to the right side, and that's caught by Dre's Anderson again, who gets the first down and a nice catch. Oh, actually, they marked him just short. Gabbert again in shotgun with Hyde, split to his right, and throws it to Hyde actually, and oh, threw it a little too soon. Had to get rid of it because of the pressure from the blitzing corner. Sets up 4th and inches. Let's see what the 49ers do here. They're going to need 2 touchdowns. There's a play action, throws it to the right side. That'll be enough for the first down to Vance McDonald, who is hit and looks like he came up limping on that play, but there was also a holding, so that'll set up they'll have to get 4th and 10, and Vance McDonald got hurt on that play. That was a terrible all-around play. Vance McDonald is going to be out for several weeks, is what the diagnosis is said to be. So that sets up 4th and 10 now. Blake Bell checks in as tight end number 1. Gabbert back to pass. Throws it short to Blake Bell, and that is incomplete, and that will do it for the 49ers. Got a question that play call there as they throw it short on 4th and 10. Didn't even give their players a chance to get that first down. But overall, the Panthers won 25-13, and it was a great effort by the 49ers after they got slaughtered last week by the Rams on Monday night. Great overall defensive effort as they were able to hold the Panthers defense, did a bend not break defense, and I think that's going to become the identity for this defense is bend don't break. Let them get into the red zone, but hold them before they get into the end zone. And give them all these field goals, which was a great and gave us our offense an opportunity to take the lead. Only if a couple of those fumbles went our ways, you never know what could have happened. As you can see, our run game did not do well, and I'm not surprised because Panthers' front seven, like I said, is very, very good. Receiving-wise, Quinn Patton led the way with four receptions. Dre's Anderson also had three receptions, but Torrey Smith had the most receiving yards and could have had even more if he would have made that catch there and under the two-minute warning. That, who knows, this game could have went a whole different way. If he makes that catch, onside kick, we get it. You never know what can happen. You can see there's a couple of drop passes by everybody. Rod Streeter did not look very good, in my opinion. I think I'm going to put Dre's Anderson above of him in the depth chart and get Dre's Anderson some more opportunities as a young guy who just finds his way. And Navarro Bowman had a great game again. Emmanuel Chu, who I didn't mention, comes in and kind of plays every single linebacker position as a backup. Had some nice plays, but I didn't get a chance to mention him during the games or show any of his plays. Forced fumble, yeah, like I said, Navarro Bowman forced it, but nobody was able to recover it. Next week, it doesn't get any easier as we take on the Seattle Seahawks, who are led by Russell Wilson and Thomas Rawls. Doug Baldwin was a nice receiver with Tyler Lockett and Javon Kearse. Their Jimmy Graham tight end, but their offensive line is very poor, so I'm hoping our defensive line can get pressure without having to send in many guys. Their defense is not as good as it has been in years past, but it's still very dangerous when you have KJ Wright, Richard Sherman, Earl Thomas, and Cam Chancellor on it. So that will do it for this week, and leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week as we take on the Seahawks.